1 hour.
On February 8, 2019, DRDO successfully flight tested the second indigenously developed solid fuel ducted ramjet, SFDR, propulsion based missile system from ITR, Chandipur, Odisha. Ground booster, separation of ground booster and nozzle-less booster performance were found satisfactory. Unlike an earlier test in May 2018, when only the nozzle-less booster of the SFDR configuration was validated, this time the ramjet sustainer of the missile kicked in after it had been accelerated to a certain forward velocity by the nozzle-less booster. The overall scheme involves the use of a reduced smoke nozzle-less rocket booster to first accelerate the missile to a certain Mach number at which the ramjet sustainer can achieve ignition and start delivering the thrust. It is the ramjet which then propels the missile at high supersonic speeds for engaging targets at extended ranges. According to DRDO sources, the missile achieved a sustained speed of close to Mach 3 thanks to the successful operation of its ramjet. The success of SFDR propulsion technology is a significant milestone and will pave the way for the development of long-range air-to-air missiles in the country. While the solid fuel booster rocket, SFDR combination has been a tried and tested means of propulsion, it has limitations of maximum engagement ranges against agile and maneuvering targets like manned combat aircraft, which can bleed the energy of the VRAM. To improve terminal stage maneuvering, present-day VRAMs use multi-pulse solid fuel rocket motors, with the second pulse firing taking place only in the terminal stages after the VRAM's Ka or Ku-band active seeker has locked onto its target. The MBDA-developed Meteor VRAM was the first to do away with the need for multi-pulse solid-fuel rocket motors by incorporating a throttleable ducted rocket, TDR, version of a solid-fuel ramjet developed by Germany-based Bayern Chemie. The TDR functions as an extended sustainer with the variable thrust being generated by a solid propellant, but can sustain high thrust levels for far longer periods since it acquires its oxidizer from the air. However, both VRAMs and LRAMs using SFDR have a limitation. Ramjet motors are heavier and take time to reach maximum speed in the initial phases, and are thus less agile. Consequently, VRAMs and LRAMs using SFDRs will be less effective against agile MRCAs, but the LRAM will be highly effective against lumbering combat support platforms like UNCS aircraft and aerial refueling tankers.